Hi everyone, welcome back. So in today's video, we'll be discussing about sine bar. This is a precise angle measuring instrument. In previous videos, we have discussed about some instruments like vernier caliper, micrometer and slip gauges. Those are involved in linear dimensions measurements, maybe length or height. So now we'll first see the introductory part of the sine bar, what exactly the sine bar is, and then we'll move towards its working principle, and then we will see actual measurements by using this sine bar. We will take one workpiece and with the help of this sine bar, we will see how to measure the angle of that particular workpiece. We will discuss complete setup. And finally, we will discuss its advantages and disadvantages. So let us start with some introductory part. So this schematic represents sine bar where you will be having multiple faces. The important face is upper surface or upper face, then we'll be having two end surfaces, this one and this one, these two surfaces, and then lower surface, this surface. And most importantly, there are two setting rollers. These rollers are involved in the measurements. Basically, this upper surface and these two rollers are involved in the actual measurements, and hence these surfaces, these two rollers and this upper surface is made up with very high surface finish, and the distance between these two rollers is standardized, which can be indicated with this capital letter L. And as this sine bar is bulky and heavy, some relief holes are provided, maybe 3 or 4 relief holes are there in this sine bar. So now we'll be moving toward So this was basically the construction of sine bar. Now we'll be moving toward this working principle. So here you have to consider the schematic of this setup. Let us take an example. If I am having this workpiece and if I wanted to measure the angles included by this inclined surface with horizontal, means if I want to measure this angle, then here you have to apply the principle of opposite angles. Means now I am drawing the line which is exactly parallel to this inclined line in this way. So this line may be AB and CD. Line AB and CD are parallel to each other, and these two lines are connected with the help of one line BC. In that case, this angle theta, which is equal to this angle, means angle CBA is equal to angle BCD. Right? This is the principle of opposite angles. The same principle we have to apply here with the help of this sine bar. So what you have to do, the first step, you have to put your object on the sine bar in this way. This is sine bar. I have kept my object or workpiece whose angle need to be measured over the sine bar. And then the second step, you have to lift the sine bar. Why? To make this inclined surface horizontal. First step, I just repeat. First step, I have to put my object or workpiece whose angle need to be measured on the sine bar in this way. And then this is second step, that I have to lift this sine bar. And the reason, this is because I have to make this inclined surface as horizontal. And how to lift this? I have to put some sine blocks here, maybe in this way, or slip gauges. You have to keep adding these slip blocks here until you make this surface completely horizontal. And to make it horizontal, you need to use this indicator. This is dial indicator. So you can move this dial indicator either toward left or towards right. And here exactly you will be getting readings. For example, if this workpiece is in this way, And if you are, see, this dial indicator knob is here. If you are moving this dial indicator towards right, then what will happen? This will go on rotating in this direction because this is inclined surface. So until and unless you will get a very small deviation. See, there will be some deviations. This may deviate here up to this. This may deviate here up to this. So this small deviations will be there, and this is because of the roughness of this surface. But this is accepted. Even half revolution here, half revolution there, it is accepted. And if it is deviating in this region, then yes, you can say this surface is become completely horizontal. Okay, so we have seen the first step. I have to just put my workpiece on this surface of the sine bar. Then I have to lift the sine bar with the help of the slip blocks, and then I have to ensure whether lifted workpiece surface, upper surface, or the inclined surface is completely horizontal or not. That we can ensure with the help of this dial indicator. Now see, we know that the slip blocks you can use maybe of 20 mm, 30 mm, 20 mm, or 10 mm. In this way, multiple slip blocks you can use, and you know this height. So this height would be h, because I know these dimensions, so I could able to measure this height. And one more dimension that we know, this is a standard dimension, this distance between center lines of these two setting rollers. This distance is standard distance, and we do have this sine bar which is having the center distance is 200 mm. And now at the time of actual measurements, we will see what heights we should require, or we will get this value as well. Okay, so now we will be applying the principle of opposite angle. So see, I have to measure this angle. I'm just extending, or I'm just drawing a line which is passing through this surface in this way. Okay, I'm just again drawing the line in this way. Means this is a horizontal line, this one is horizontal line. Means these two lines are parallel to each other, and in between I have drawn one inclined line, or the line which is joining these two horizontal lines. Then now I should get this value. This value is theta. This value is nothing but this angle. This angle and this angle. That is the ultimate purpose, that I have to measure this angle. Okay, this is nothing but this angle theta. So as these two are parallel lines and joined with the single line, then obviously this line should be, this angle should be theta. So with the help of this sine bar, we'll be able to measure this angle. And this angle we can consider sine of theta, which is equal to opposite side divided by hypotenuse. So this is hypotenuse and this is opposite side. So this is h divided by this l. This can be called as l. Okay, so we have to apply this formula in order to find out the value of this theta. Now let us move towards the actual measurements. We'll see different setup and we'll find out the value of h. We'll keep it here, put it here, and then we'll be getting value of this theta. This is the setup required for the angle measurements by using sine bar. This is the sine bar. So let us discuss all the components of this setup. This is sine bar. We have discussed these are two setting rollers, and the distance between, center distance between this roller and this roller, as you can see here, it is 200 mm. So this point, so this center distance is 200 mm. We do have one object. We are going to measure angle of this object. So this is a workpiece.
So we need to measure this angle, angle of this inclined surface with this horizontal surface. And the next component that we are having is this dial indicator. So this is magnetic dial indicator, means we will be having this knob. So when you rotate this knob, we won't be able to move this dial indicator, and we do have this adjustment. With the help of this adjustment, we can make this dial indicator down or up, and then with the help of this knob, we can make the angle adjustment, and there is one knob to make this as zero adjustment. By rotating this knob, we can make the initial position as zero. So you can observe the scales of this dial indicator. There are basically two scales. See, outer divisions, when there will be one revolution, then basically the distance moved, axial distance moved, is 1 mm. So as you can see here, the one division of this main scale, one division of this main scale is nothing but 0.01 mm. Means when there will be a one revolution, complete one revolution, then the axial movement of this knob will be 1 mm. So one revolution is equal to 1 mm axial movement. So there is a second scale here. So this division is nothing but 1 mm. When this one revolution will be completed, this hand will move to one division. So this is 1 mm, and this one division is 0.01 mm. So now, as we have explained, so now we have to make this surface horizontally in this way, and to make it horizontal, we have to place sign gauges here. So we do have these different sign blocks. So we have to put the sign block in this way. We have to follow trial and error method. So once one block is placed here, we have to check it with the help of this dial indicator whether it is completely horizontal or not. So we have to move this dial indicator over this surface. So you can see the gap is there. So we have to adjust the dial indicator. We have to touch this probe to the surface of the workpiece, and then we need to make zero adjustment on this dial indicator. Okay, now as you can see, as soon as you will move, there is a gap on the right side, means you have to add the slip block over it, because there is a slope, as you can see, gap on the right side. However, this probe is touched on the left side, so there is a slope. So you have to add one slip block here so that this will become completely horizontal. So you have to do it on trial and error basis. So we will be adding the block of 4.5 mm. So this block which is added, which is of 90 mm, and we will add one small block which is of 2.5 mm. This is 80 mm block, and we are adding one small block which is of 2.5 mm. We have to place it here in this way. And again, we have to come back to this dial indicator to see whether this surface is become completely horizontal or not. You have to adjust, every time you have to adjust this dial indicator so that it will perfectly touch to this surface. You have to make zero adjustments. Again, you can observe the dial indicator. As we are moving it on the surface, see, there will be a little deviations. Those deviations are accepted. This is because of this surface. This is a wooden surface and this is a rough surface. If the surface finishes better, then obviously there will be no deviations, or very small deviations. So this is accepted, and now we can say this surface has become horizontal completely. So now, as we have discussed, that we have to measure this distance. So this distance is nothing but the length of this slip block. So 80 plus 2.5. So 82.5, this is the vertical distance, and we know that this distance is 200 mm. So based on that, we can find out this angle. So sine theta is equal to front side 82.5 divided by length between these two centers, which is 200 mm. So you will be able to get this angle, and this angle is nothing but, so this is opposite angle to this angle. If you can draw the horizontal line here and here, then the angle included here is the opposite angle. So theta is nothing but the angle included by this surface with this inclined part.
And now we can put these values here in this formula, and we'll be able to find out the value of theta. So sine theta is equal to h. This h is 82.5 mm. So you can put it here, 82.5 divided by this L for the sine bar we have used is 200. Okay, so this is nothing but 82.5 divided by 200. It is 0.4125 sine theta. So from this we will be able to find out value of this theta. So theta is equal to sine inverse 0.4125, and the answer is 24.36 degrees. So this is the angle of the workpiece we have used for the measurement. So in this way we can measure any inclined faces or surfaces of workpieces or objects. Those can be manufactured, those are manufactured in the industry. And now we'll be moving towards sine bar advantages and disadvantages. Here, as you can see, there are only few advantages this sine bar is having as compared to disadvantages. So the first important advantage is it is a precise and accurate angle measuring instrument. And then second, we have seen the construction of sine bar. So it is very simple in design and construction. And third, it is easily available. It can be manufactured easily, and hence it is available easily as compared to other angle measuring instruments. So these are the three important advantages are there. So moving toward disadvantage. So yes, it is true that it is a precise and accurate angle measuring instrument, but it is only precise and accurate for angles less than 15 degrees. When the angles are more than 15 degrees, maybe from 15 degrees to 45 degrees, this preciseness or accuracy will be reduced. There are many reasons due to this sine bar or incomplete setup, some errors will be established, and due to that, this accuracy and preciseness will be reduced. So the angles which are greater than 45 degrees, so it becomes impractical to use sine bar to measure angles more than 45 degrees. We can still use it to measure the angles in between 15 to 45 degrees, but yes, accuracy and preciseness will be reducing. But it is precise and accurate for angles less than 15 degrees. So second, as we have discussed, it is heavy and bulky, the weight is more, so obviously it is difficult to handle. And third, as it is heavy, so the deformation will be there in contact between this roller and slip gauges. We have discussed that rollers or the sine bar is lifted with the help of these slip gauges. So this deformation increases. Okay, so this deformation causes errors and slight errors. See the last point, slight errors in the sine bar causes large angular errors. See, we have discussed how to carry out the actual measurements. So it depends on the surface on which we are carrying out the measurement should be completely flat or should have a better surface finish. And then this roller should have better surface finish, that upper face of the sine bar should have better surface finish. But still, when the weight of the object when the weight of the object, see, the objects need to be placed on the sine bar itself. So if the weight of the objects or the heavy objects are there, then definitely this sine bar is becomes, it is not becomes feasible, or we cannot use for the sine bar to measure angles of these heavy objects. And even though for the angles less than 15 degrees, but if the work pieces are very heavy, then it is not feasible to use sine bar. So rather you can use some other instruments, maybe bevel protractor or clinometer. So in this way, sine bar can only be used to measure the angles of work pieces of light objects and angle which is less than 15 degrees. It is highly preferred to use it to measure the angle less than 15 degrees and object should be light. So in this way we can use sine bar to measure different angles of a workpiece. So I hope you understand what exactly the sine bar is and how to use this sine bar, this complete setup, to measure different angles of a workpiece. So from next video we'll be discussing about surface texture measurements.